Hallelujah. Oh, I see new Mercedes. I see all that. I see the blessing of the Lord. What's on me is already on you. It's already on you. We know that financial authority. I want to pray one prayer over the 70 who God is nurturing to plant a seed of 160,000 naira. This seed's not for me. It's not for the building. It's to sow into a man of God who has led and shepherded our lives in this house. This 160,000 naira, which is $1,000, is where I broke the back of poverty. I didn't ask him for permission to do this. I just know I can't leave here. I cannot leave here until the same anointing that's on me settles on you 70. And everything you touch explodes with the blessing of the Lord. Everything you touch explodes. There's going to be some surprise miracles. There's going to be some surprise favor. And you're going to get telephone calls and sit there speechless. I cannot believe this is God. It's going to happen so fast, so fast. I did not know. Late last night, there's a young lady, calls me her dad. And she comes from a very poor family in Pakistan. Trying to go through Bible school, didn't have a penny to go through Bible school. God spoke to me last night, put her through 2 years of Bible school, pay all of her bills, pay all of her fund. And I tweeted her back and I said, I will pay all of your bills for Bible school for the next 2 years and everything that you need. And she tweeted back, she said, I'm crying. I can't believe it. I didn't have any money. My father doesn't have a good job. We're very, very poor. God has just answered. That's what's going to happen to the 70 in this house. There's going to be a phone call. I said, there's going to be a phone call, and you're going to stand there and say, that's for me. That's for me. All across this room, I want the 70 who know God has given you extra seed to sow. The 160,000 naira, this is going to be a seed of honor for the man and woman of God over this house. Lift your right hand high. If you're one of the 70, lift your right hand high. Lift it high. Keep it there for just a moment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is the greatest ground you'll ever sow into all your life. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. There's somebody in the other building, I think. 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54. Did I miss someone? 55. Who done it? 56, 57. Who the other, what's that, 13 more? There's some. Can you count them in the other building? Is these musicians over here? Hallelujah. That's good. That's good seed. Good seed. Hallelujah. Anybody else? Anybody else? There's others. Hallelujah. This is the other. I'm looking. Wow, that's a good looking group of people there. Praise God. Those that are in the, what do you call that place? Right next door? If you feel God stirring you to sow this 160,000 naira, if you're one of the 70, lift your hand high and wave it across the lake. Wave it to us right there. Wave it where you are. I see one. Yes, I see there. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many, if God was to give this to you in the next 30 days, supernaturally you would sow it? If God was to give you an extra 160,000 naira, we'll fill this out. Pastor, every one of us that lifted our hand will fill this out on an envelope, and we need to put it in your hand. We need to put it in your hand. We'll put your name on the envelope. Wave a hand high. Father, I decree financial authority on every one of these that are sanctifying this special seed of 160,000 naira. I wrap faith around this, and every miracle you give him and his wife, let that same miracle come to us. Every time you open a door for them, open a door for us. We believe that the seed controls our future, and we wrap expectation around it in the name of Jesus. Father, I call the tithe today. holy. And within 7 days from today, by next Sunday, we will see the first wave of harvest. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Please, you may be seated. In Genesis chapter 8, verse 22, it says, "While the earth remaineth, seed time and harvest time shall not cease." It's only your obedience to the word of God that obligates your harvest. It's offering time. Please package a quality offering that reflects God's blessings in your life. Remember your vows. Remember your tithe. If you've done it, lift it above your head and bless God with it. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we magnify you for this opportunity we have to give back to you out of the much you've given us. Lord, we ask that you bless every hand that's lifted up in giving unto you. In the name of Jesus.
Him and exalt him. In Jesus' mighty name, to God be all the glory. You may be seated. One of the testimonies came out of today's meeting. Towards the end of the church service, I made a statement. I said, "You don't draw virtue on a vessel you don't play value on." The woman with the issue of blood placed value on Jesus, and she was able to tap of the virtue he carried. The prophet you don't recognize, you can't gain any profit from him. We know that God's servant has been a blessing to us since Wednesday. Will still be a blessing even after he has gone. It's not that it's a blessing when he's here alone. The impact will go beyond when physically he's here. We are privileged to have him. He said it's the first time in 65 years he will preach 6:30 in the morning. We don't take it for granted. We appreciate it's a lot of sacrifice to preach 5 services. Supposed to be, even now, it's still morning where he's coming from. Because Dallas now is 6 hours, about 6 hours difference with Nigeria. It's about, it's still early morning, early hours. So they're about waking up to prepare. And he's here preaching from midnight to early morning. So I won't take your time but your hardship because I've been so blessed. And I'm sure you have been blessed. There's so many things I can't say when he's seated. It's when he's gone, I'll be able to say all. Because I'll be able to say before him all it is in my heart. So we join our heart. Let's have the electronics introduction and then we'll hear God's word. I want your heart to be set. Something will happen to you.
Its own reward. If I'm straight with God, straight with men, there is a great confidence in it. But you lose confidence when you're not straight. Your seed is what God called the price. Expectation is why you bought the price. Remember, your future will require more than your present requirement. Your future has a different expectation than your present. Your present knowledge got you to now. But the knowledge from here on out will take you to your future.
Dr. Mike Murdoch is the founder and senior pastor of Wisdom Center, a world outreach church organization based in Fort Worth, Texas, in USA. He has embraced his assignment to pursue proclaim and publish the wisdom of God to help people achieve their dreams and goals. Dr. Mike is a motivational and dynamic speaker and teacher of the Word of God with undeniable results. He preached his first sermon at the age of 8 and began full-time evangelism at the age of 19. Today, he receives hundreds of invitations to speak in churches, colleges, and business corporations. He has traveled and spoken to over 20,000 audiences in more than 40 countries, including East and West Africa, the Orient, Europe, and South America. Wisdom Center, which he presides over, extends an arm of love to the unsaved and the body of Christ around the world. This includes feeding 1,000 children in Mexico every day, full sponsorship for Asian Bible College, Southern India, and lots more. He is also the host of the weekly TV program Wisdom Keys, which is viewed globally, particularly through international networks such as TBN, CBN, BET, Inspiration, Daystar, and many others. Millions have been tremendously impacted through this program. As a prolific writer, he has authored over 200 books, including bestsellers such as The Assignment, Dream Seeds, The Law of Recognition, 31 Secrets for Career Success, and a host of others. He created a topical Bible series for businessmen, fathers, mothers, and teenagers. He is also the creator of the Master 7 Mentorship System, an achievement program for believers. Dr. Mike Murdoch is uniquely blessed with a voice and the ability to compose songs. As a gospel musician, he has written thousands of songs, some of which include I'm Blessed, God Rides on the Wings of Love, and You Can Make It. With a loud ovation to the Lord Jesus and great joy in our hearts, shall we all rise to our feet as we welcome God's wisdom bank, mentor, leader, and gospel luminary, Dr. Mike Murdoch.
Praise God. Thank you, family. Thank you. Hold your Bible close to your heart. I love sitting at your feet. I love hearing what you say. I love hearing what you say. I love knowing your desires. I love knowing your desires. I'm so pleasured to obey. I'm so pleasured to obey. Your favor is like sunrise. Your favor is like sunrise. Driving all my nights away. All my nights away. I love sitting at your feet every single day. Yes, yes, yes. I love sitting at your feet every single day. Let's pray this prayer together. Precious Holy Spirit, you are my master mentor. You are my trusted teacher. I love your voice. I have a passion for your presence. I love your teaching me, comforting me, talking to me, protecting me. I'm so thankful for you. Today I'm a receiver of your mercy, of your instructions, of your correction, of your wisdom. I really need your wisdom. Put a new mantle of wisdom on my life.